sky blue gets dark enough to see the colors of the city lights. A trail of ruby, red, and diamond white.
Muted. Ha. Just kidding. That's when that backfires. Woo! Hello.
Welcome to the show.
Welcome. All right.
Welcome. Oh, that's so cool. The music sounded good today, Chris.
Hey, I can't take credit for that. That's
John Mayer all day.
Our friend John Mayer. Yeah. There. We'll give it up for John.
Yeah. Give it up for John.
I will. More to come on that later. That's right.
Yeah.
Shannon doesn't know about it, but, you know.
This will be fun.
Yeah. Also, if you didn't happen to notice, we're coming to you live from the backyard. All right, so give it up for that.
I love our backyard. It's my favorite thing.
It's almost like we could add that right to pretty. Favorite things.
Do it.
Little oasis.
Yes, absolutely. Well, welcome to the show, you guys. We've got a good one today. We've got a very, very special guest.
Yes, we do.
So thank you for joining us. I'll let Chris do the introduction. Of course, as usual, we have the Brian Paolillo, the man.
Oh, the man.
The myth. Yeah. The myth.
But first, let's get to Anthony Meisner.
The legend.
Sorry about that. Yeah. You got a little ahead of
the
us.
The other. Yes. He's the other. He's
the other. We've got the other man, the myth, legend.
Yeah.
With land title. Go ahead, Chris.
All right. So Anthony Meisner is here. Thank you very much. This is going to be awesome. We've got some really cool stuff to talk about. Some current, current events and just some awesome investor strategies. So thanks for joining us there.
Yeah, thanks for coming in.
Yeah, that's sweet.
Yeah, thanks, Anthony.
We also, of course, always we've got Brian Paolillo.
Yes, boom.
Sometimes.
And he's not Anthony Meisner. He's
Brian Paolillo.
Brian Paolillo.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Well, thanks for coming in. Yeah. It's going to be a good one. Let's go right into it. Let's talk about our favorite things.
Oh, you want to go to favorite things?
Favorite things, yes. Right. Oh, we missed that last time, I think.
We did miss our favorite things.
And I don't want to miss it today.
Yeah. We should start with the one behind your head with the
Light
Avalanche.
Like, let me get out of the way.
Yeah.
How do
Let's
I
do that. Can you see it? Mm. Yeah.
Go Avs.
Yes, go Avs. Chris pulled that out of the
backstop.
It's always been there. It's always been there.
Always been there.
So go Avs.
Go Avs. That's right. Yeah. So we are going to talk about, what's the next segment? It's our favorite things.
Yes.
All right. So as usual, we've got the Diet
Do.
We're still waiting for that sound bite, Brian, of cracking a do.
Yeah.
So
yep. Thanks for the picture. I saw it.
If you could get on that.
All I can do is drink it. Come on.
Yep. Okay. We'll take that. The other favorite thing is our fire sauce from Taco Beezy. It's the best.
It's so good. It's the best. It's so good. And always, and I'm switching it up.
What? What's this?
Oh. Oh, yeah.
Oh, gosh. He's got music behind him today. I think we're in trouble.
Oh, Shannon's in trouble.
I think you're in trouble, yeah. It's got nothing to do with us.
Lovely. Yeah. Brought to you by the other John Mayer guitar.
Oh, great. John Mayer.
Oh, yeah.
The actual
Which he may have just bought. May or may not have just bought.
I hope not.
No say on that.
Yes.
One.
Okay, go to the Avalanche. Oh, that's a fun quote. The people who are crazy enough to think that they can change the world are the ones who actually do. I just thought that was fun. I feel like I'm crazy enough sometimes to change the world, and hopefully I can.
Yeah.
Speaking of changing the world.
Yep, here we go.
Oh!
Avalanche.
Oh, yeah.
They're slaying.
Oh, it seems a bit quiet from the Floridians today.
Yeah.
I don't know. I haven't heard much.
The Floridians. I will say
nervous.
Yeah, they are nervous. They're coming back to Colorado.
Oh,
We're on what game?
It's over.
What game are we on? Five?
It'll be game five Friday.
Game five is Friday. I can't wait.
Lights out, right?
Yes. Lights out. We're going into it. Who's been watching Obi-Wan on Disney Plus? Anybody?
Oh, that's great.
We have.
Oh, I have. It's pretty good. Don't spoil anything. I know we've missed an episode.
I'm watching it on the plane.
It's so good, Brian. It's good.
I'm super excited. I got them downloaded already.
Yeah. Okay, good.
No, that's what's up, man.
Yeah, it's doing it. So, and then let's go to our last favorite thing of Anthony's. I'll let him explain it here as soon as Chris gets it on the screen.
Right here?
Yep, that's it.
Okay, sorry.
Yep, boom. What is this, Anthony?
Oh, well, that's chess, because chess is awesome. Well, my 5-year-old and I play a lot of chess together. That happens to be his Lego chessboard. His two favorite things in the whole world, Legos and chess.
Oh, so I love that. And he's five and he's playing chess?
Yeah, he's been playing since his 5th birthday or maybe even a little before that. And he is just crushing it now.
Love it. Wow. That's really impressive. Well, good job, Dad.
That's right.
Yeah, that's pretty cool.
5 years old.
5 years
Goals
old. Yeah.
Over here.
Yeah, I know. I need to learn how. Maybe he can teach me. All right. Last but not least, this could not my favorite thing. This is not my favorite
Who
thing
took
right
this
now.
No.
I'm
curious.
That's Brian's picture.
That was me. I was.
There's no 87 $80 going in
$80 later. Filling up the gas tank was
a
little bit of a...
It's brutal.
It's been terrible. I literally got my car stopped at Costco the other day because they hit $100 and it can't... That was it. That was all they were going to give me.
Oh, my gosh.
Oh, that's not
they
even...
They stop it? That's not enough. Why do they stop it at Costco? You'd think they'd want a little more...
I mean, maybe it's a credit card thing. I don't know. It's ridiculous, though.
Oh, my gosh. Painful. Well, I'm sorry about that. Well, what have you been up to, Brian? I think you sent me this one. What is this picture that...
Those are... Those are the lilies in the backyard. They finally started blooming. So
nice. Yes.
The grasses. Nice. You can kind of see in the corner, Carrie's got her pool going up. So she's super excited.
I was wondering about that. I haven't seen any pictures of the pool.
She's poolside.
She's poolside.
Yeah, that'll be the next show. You be pool. Well, no, it won't because
you're going on a jet plane. He'll probably be oceanside.
He'll be checking in. Brian's checking from around the world.
I can't wait. I can't wait.
Yeah, I'm super excited. So.
And then what's this, Brian? What are you doing here? It looks fun.
Little Father's Day. Sean and I went. Sean, who's one of my good friends, we went shooting for Father's Day. So it was pretty fun. So
good.
And I screwed around and got a little brass therapy.
Speaking of Father's Day, I know it's not a father.
Oh yeah,
yeah,
It's not her grandbaby. That's our that's our client's grandbaby and Brian's mother-in-law. Sandy holding the baby. I'm super jealous that she got to go see little baby Aram. So congratulations, of course, to Sid and Brandon on their new addition. Yeah. I think he's about a week old, and this kid has more hair than Chris, which is really hard to do right now. But he's
way to point that out.
I
had to throw that in there. Write it down. But the baby is so cute, and first-time parents and first-time Father's Day, and I'm
jealous. Aramie and Steve are first-time grandparents,
who
are great friends from, I've known them, since middle school. So
I can't.
They're the
best. Yeah, congratulations to them.
We are so happy
super
for
excited
them.
For them.
And this awesome addition to their family.
Yep, to our family, actually. Our everybody's family. Families,
Yeah.
And then what are you doing here, Brian? You got a fancy hat on, and it looks like you're in a very safe house.
So new construction, walking through, checking it out and pointing out all the fun pieces of the house. It's getting its rough inspections over the next couple of days, and so that's kind of where we're at. We're looking at a September finish date, and super excited about it. So
The views at this house. Can you go to the view picture right here? The views at this house are insane. Like, they're so beautiful.
So that'll do. That's
yeah.
from the bass. Woo. That's from the master bedroom.
Can't complain there.
I'd love to wake up to
that. Yeah, you could wake up to that.
I would like to wake up every morning to that.
It's a cool...
I wouldn't complain.
Yeah. And then congratulations. We sold a house for our buyers this week. This one went under list. I think Brian got it maybe almost 20,000 under list. He'll have to pop back in here. But really strong negotiation.
Crushing it
for our clients. So nice job, Brian.
We also
getting that under contract.
Got this one under contract.
We did. Fastest acceptance deadline.
Boom.
Our acceptance signature. I submitted the contract to our seller's agent at 5:10, and I had a seller's signature by 5:34. So by 24 minutes after submission, the seller accepted our offer. So
I would say that's how you know you wrote a good contract.
Do you think so?
I do.
Okay.
That's what I'm going to go with.
Well, that's interesting. And Anthony, what are you doing here? Did we lose
him? Oh, well, this is the summer of fun because it's 2022. So we're axe throwing here. And of course, I think I threw a knife in this one and hit the bullseye, which, obviously.
Slinging.
My wife, Shannon, you may not know this about her, but interestingly, she is an expert axe thrower.
Expert axe thrower.
Well, I won't say she's an expert in that she has a lot of experience, But she just is good.
I can get them in there.
Oh yeah, she is.
Yeah, so we should go hang out and do that.
That'd be awesome.
See who's doing it the best here. And then what are you doing right here, Anthony?
On a boat.
On a boat.
Oh, that's my youngest son, Owen. We are fishing. We spend a lot of time out at the lake. We love it. So.
Oh, sweet. I love it. Yeah, and then the next picture you sent me earlier, you guys are, it looks like you're having a lot of fun. What are you doing here?
Oh, we're at Colorado National Speedway. That's my five-year-old, the chess guru, but I took him to the races, and that's one of my clients that invited us to go. Of course,
fun.
You know, we're like sitting in the luxury seats and had to go down all the way across the entire stadium to get the cotton candy. So
of course you did. Yeah. There's no going to a event like that without getting cotton candy. So you got to go to the ends of the earth for that.
Well, and I totally have memories of going to these when I was a kid, and same thing, like it's good that he has that ear protection. Yeah. Those cars.
Oh
are
yeah.
Loud.
They're loud. Oh, my. And they are cruising too. Cruising. So
that's Colorado National Speedway that night was doing like a lot of the figure eight races too, which are always just so fascinating.
Yeah. That's fun.
Super cool.
Well, and then we threw a surprise birthday party for my stepmom over the weekend, which I've never done before. And we surprised her with about 30 of her friends and family and people that flew in from out of town. And she turned 60 years old on Sunday. So happy belated birthday, Grandma Judy.
Grandma.
We love you. Yes. Shout out to her. And
we took her to the
Gaylord. We took her to the Gaylord, which was a lot of fun.
Yeah, that was awesome.
Went swimming and hung out by the poolside all day on Sunday. And that's Chris there with our youngest daughter doing a little
some routines in the pool.
So it was fun.
Right. It was awesome.
But let's roll right into what we're going to talk about after all that today. This is Anthony. What are you doing here, dude? What is this? You're doing a presentation. It looks like there's a lot of people in the room, and it says hackers. You're going to have to explain all of that.
Oh, yeah. So I love to speak. And so I've been traveling for like 4 years now around Colorado, speaking on cryptocurrency and the blockchain and real estate and how that's all working out. And this was actually a few weeks ago up in Basalt for the Aspen Board of Realtors. They put together this great place, like 150 people, brand new stage up in Basalt that they had this sweet new build area that got all done. And they invited me to come speak. So, I mean, how could I not? How fun to go take work as an excuse to head up to the mountains for a few days.
Yeah, you just need to get up there during the winter. Like, write that down, winter, let's go snowboarding, let's go there.
That's fair, except for the fact that in the Aspen market, in that area, you can't afford to ski up there in the winter, but you can absolutely go, like, enjoy the hiking in the summer, because it's, like, one of the most beautiful places in Colorado.
Oh, yeah, fishing, everything else, it's beautiful.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Yeah. Well, let's roll right into it. Let's talk about it. What are we talking about?
Yeah.
Cryptocurrency, real estate, how to do it.
Yeah, so Anthony, if I'm a we have a bunch of investor clients, they love crypto. What do they need to do to utilize cryptocurrency in order to purchase a home? So kind of walk us through that. What would be the steps involved in that?
Yeah, so cryptocurrency in real estate, it's a very interesting thing. I think there's a few really, really important things to remember first and foremost. Number one, cryptocurrency is treated as an asset class in the United States, right? So that's the most important thing to remember when structuring anything. Cryptocurrency is not good funds in Colorado, or, well, I don't know about the rest of the country, but at least when we talk about Colorado real estate, cryptocurrency has only a couple things that matter most. It's an asset, so it has to be treated like an asset. Colorado is a really cool state where asset transfers are kind of ingrained into our culture. Because of back in the day, we're the Wild West here in Colorado, right? People forget that maybe 100 years ago, people were legitimately like trading cattle for land or trading land for land. Or, you know, if I wanted to trade a condo here in Boulder for something up in the mountains and I wanted to do a straight across swap, like that stuff's cool in Colorado. No big deal, right? We have real estate law for that. So that's kind of how the cryptocurrency stuff is structured in real estate. That's like the short and skinny of it. But in all reality, it gets pretty complicated because a lot of people aren't comfortable with this stuff yet, right? We can't really write real estate contracts in Bitcoin or in Ethereum. So the big thing we have to remember is, first of all, the act of purchasing real estate with cryptocurrency is absolutely possible. What we want to know and what we need to kind of navigate is, what are the tax implications and how does that look? And are the sellers going to take your cryptocurrency? Because that's always like the hardest thing of all. But it's absolutely possible we can get it done. You know, we're well, I pretty much have to get involved with all of them because I've been barking up people's trees for like the last 4 years to make these happen. But it's just a fun place to meet people. It's a great environment. You know, back in like 2018, we had this big investor that came to town and wanted to buy up a ton of real estate across the country using crypto. And that's really why we dove down the rabbit hole, right? I mean, and if people are willing to spend enough money, like somebody somewhere is going to figure out how to get it done. So, you know, I spent 4 months back and forth with our legal team, and eventually they're like, all right, well, let's do this. We can treat them like asset transfers. We had some attorneys involved, and we just kind of made the whole process happen.
So what does that look like if I'm, let's say I want to buy a house in crypto, you're saying it's an asset. Am I going to pay capital gains on that? Is there money set aside for capital gains?
Yeah, so the craziest thing about buying and selling in cryptocurrency is you really want, you know, you really want to understand the tax laws first. So the act of buying a home is a taxable event, right? So that means that capital gains taxes have to be paid at the time or whenever, I guess, you file your taxes for the year. But let's say you pay $1 million for a house. If you pay a crypto for the vast majority of it, or for everything outside of, you know, taxes, insurance, water, sewer, all those escrow things that we normally have to put through title, real estate commissions in most cases, a lot of people pay those in US dollars instead of Bitcoin. But lately people are like, I'll take my commissions in Bitcoin too. But that really depends on if people can do that or not. But let's just call it 93% of the entire process could be done in Bitcoin. That has to be transferred peer-to-peer. So that's taking place outside of our traditional escrow process, but at that time, that is subject to capital gains on that day, right? Because the act of buying or selling a home is a taxable event in itself. So those two things are tied together, right? We can't just avoid capital gains by trading Bitcoin for real estate, right? It's not a 1031 where we could take deferred real estate taxes and not pay them and put it into the next property, right? They're two completely separate asset classes. So we have to treat them that way.
Okay. And then what about, so what's the next step? So we take it, you guys help facilitate getting it set up and transferring the good funds after we make the sale of Bitcoin. We sell that, it comes into you, or is it just a straight exchange? We're giving
Bitcoin. Well,
this
depends on how you want to structure it, right? The vast majority of people that come in with cryptocurrency that want to buy end up having to pay in US dollars, not because not because it can't happen in Bitcoin, right? It's mainly because the seller wants US dollars. They, over the course of a contract period, have a better chance of selling off their stuff at the prices that they want to get for it and give it to the seller on the seller's terms, right? We have to remember that real estate is a matter of price and terms, right? And if the terms are Bitcoin, chances are that's gonna drop the price or raise the price at which you have to pay, right? I mean, you're probably paying a premium to pay with Bitcoin. Well, since it's a taxable event anyway, I would say 99% of the time, people that are coming from cryptocurrency funds end up cashing out somewhere along the process, sometimes all the way up until the day of closing, right? I mean, it's pretty easy to take $1 million and turn it into US dollars from crypto or vice versa now. So being that it's such a commonly traded asset, it's pretty easy to kind of time that as best as you can before closing. But, you know, we're seeing a lot more of that. So that's kind of scenario one. We work through that a lot. But in all reality, as long as you have a really good title partner like Land Title, you have a good lender partner, if lenders are involved, so they understand, like, you know, down payments may be coming from crypto, then that's all okay. But the key there is if you have a lender involved, you have a title insurance company involved, they have to know what's going on with this. They have to be okay with it. I mean, there's some big title companies out there that void your title insurance if you are using cryptocurrency for your down payment. You know, Fannie Freddie says they don't care if it comes from crypto. It just has to be sold off before closing, right? So they don't mind that, you know, you made $50,000 in college and, you know, day trading while you were taking some investment classes and thought crypto was cool, because this happens all the time, especially here in Boulder. And then you're like, I don't know, I got my first job, worked for Google, and I need to buy a house. Like, why don't I buy this townhouse and use my crypto earnings as my down payment, right? Wow. That's really commonplace. But that all ends up coming through the escrow process, right? Because if it goes into US dollars, it can get wired into Land Title. We do exactly what we do on every other deal. Now, Sweet. Let's call it like one out of 10,000 times you actually find a seller that's willing to take your Bitcoin. The house is free and clear because, right, like you can't pay a loan off with cryptocurrency.
Right.
So since you can't do that, then we really have to transfer some funds usually anyway into cash. You can obviously do a hybrid process, but in the one out of 10,000 times where like buyer has Bitcoin, seller wants Bitcoin, you know, maybe it's a third home or a second home. They want to diversify their asset portfolio. We can definitely facilitate that, but it really requires buyer and seller to understand the process of like transferring crypto from one to another, agreeing on a place and time of the value, because obviously, like we've seen in the last week, cryptos are all over the place.
Right. all markets now. Yeah. Every market's all over the place. It's a potpourri of entertainment.
Yeah.
So is now the time to buy crypto since it's so low, or no? Since it crashed? Not the time.
Wait, what's that?
Is now the time to buy crypto in your opinion?
Yeah, so I'm obviously today speaking from my personal opinion, not from like Tidal's perspective on anything.
Correct.
Right. So with that being said, I like buying cryptocurrency when the markets are down. Yeah. It's no different than buying anything else. No. It's like buying real estate when the market's down. Just makes more sense sometimes, right? No, I'm not going to wait until the market crashes to buy anything. Yeah, but in a day like today, you got some extra money to throw at it. I don't think this is the worst time in the world.
I agree.
Interesting. Yeah. Okay, that's good feedback. I love
So Anthony, you have a podcast of your own. Why don't you tell us a little bit about that? Like, what do you talk about on your podcast?
Yeah, so I have two podcasts. Like in my day job, day to day, it's obviously not just like Bitcoin and real estate. I truly like work the Boulder market as a sales rep for Land Title. So most of what I do is market data, market stats, talking to realtors and lenders and all the other people in this marketplace about, you know, what the market's doing and just coming from a point of value. So I have a podcast called the Front Range Facts. We talk about the real estate markets all over the Colorado Front Range. But the one that's exciting and the one that everyone wants to hear about is the blockchain and real estate one. So I started that one about 4 years ago when we started this whole teaching and learning about the crypto and real estate process. And it's just been a really cool way to get CEOs from all over the world on our podcast to talk about, hey, what are you doing? Oh, you're transferring deeds to the blockchain. Like, fun. Let's have a conversation on that. Or, hey, you know, I bugged Elliot Eisenberg, the bow tie economist, who's like all over here in Colorado now. And I was like, you put something out in your on your blog about what's going on with blockchain and what's happening with, you know, these stable coins. And I'm like, I don't know if I agree with you on this. You want to come on the podcast and talk about it? Turns out we were on like the same page, but he like had a little bit different view of like the US's involvement and what's happening. And it's just a fun way to kind of interact with people in the crypto space, what's going on, what we're seeing. So that's called Get Real with Blockchain. You can get that anywhere you get podcasts. We only release, you know, like 1 to 5 episodes a year, just kind of when we meet cool people or we want to bring some new topic up, like tokenization of real estate assets or, you know, all the really down the rabbit hole stuff that you can get into.
Awesome. Great. We'll definitely be checking that out.
We'll check
it
out and put it in the comments so that we can share and get interested parties involved in that, because it all sounds great. I'm interested, so I want the links.
Yeah, you bet.
Yep. Great.
The big piece on that, I mean, it's not going anywhere. You're seeing this as as you've said, Anthony, an asset. You've seen, you know, the strides on the what it's gone up over the years is amazing. My son, who's Jake, he's up in Boulder, and you know, they just do like screwing around day trading, and you know, their gains are ridiculous. I mean, absolutely ridiculous. And I'm just like, it's like any other investment. Just know you can lose it. Be aware of it. You know,
that's the truth. Yeah. I mean, I think just like anything else, don't put money in that you're not willing to lose. So I had a lot of money back in crypto back in the day, but we were doing a bunch of mining pre the crash in 2017, 2018. And so when I got out of all of that, we pretty much took all of our crypto gains and a lot of our other gains from real estate and just reinvested them in real estate, because that's what I do for a living. That's where I might should put my money where my mouth is, probably, right?
Sure.
And maybe that'll work out, maybe it won't, but like I spend so much time day to day in real estate that crypto, like the investment portion of it is really a hobby. Like with two kids, especially at 3 and 5, I don't have time to day trade. I'm not watching that stuff. Like I need my money to work for me, but it needs to be long-term investing, right? So
for sure,
of course I have money in crypto. Of course we have money in real estate, but like it's got to be a whole portfolio. Like I have money in stocks too, just like everybody else. So I think this is just one of those things where it's really becoming commonly adopted, right? I read something the other day that said US males between 30 and 49, like 60% of them now in cryptocurrency. Like it's just widely becoming adopted, and it's right now it's semi-speculative, right? People are going, oh, well, this seems like there's going to be a good future here. That's why I'm buying. Well, that's probably why we're having this podcast, right? Because people are finally really interested. When I started teaching in 2017, 2018, I'm like, oh my God, crypto's coming. This wave is going to be so cool. Mass adoption's happening. And here we are 4 years later. And I'm like, still basic education level on cryptocurrency because people are still getting involved and it's still super fascinating and nobody knows much about it, right?
For those that are just getting their feet wet with it and want to get involved, what do you suggest? Like where would I start?
Yeah. So what I tell people in my class, if they've never touched cryptocurrency ever before, is just go download something like Coinbase and buy $5 worth of cryptocurrency and learn how to take it offline and transfer it to one of your friends. Because if you can go through that process and you can learn how it all works, you have a much better chance of understanding really what this is. But realistically, I mean, you can listen to podcasts, you can do all kinds of crazy things to get involved. If you want to learn on like what to invest in, what to buy, I really like the website coinmarketcap.com. It's just basically a place where it's like a big hub of resources for each crypto. So they're ranked by their market cap every day. It shows the gains and losses, just like if you were looking at stock. But the coolest part is if you click into, let's just call it Cardano, right? One of the top cryptocurrencies. You can get in there, you can say, what is this? What does it look like? You know, you can go to the Cardano's website, you can read the white papers, you can understand like, what's the purpose of this? Because the one thing that people don't understand when they just speculatively invest is like, what are you buying, right? That's always what people should know. They should know like, oh, I totally support this project because this CEO is a genius, or like, I like Bitcoin because it's open source and it's run by the people for the people, and it's global currency, right? Like, what's your purpose behind what you're buying, right? I'd always just say to people when they're looking at like for the first time investors, buy something you're interested in, right? And obviously don't be afraid to lose your money. Because if you buy something stupid or, you know, just something doesn't work out for them, I mean, through the years, it'll be like somebody announces a deal with Visa and of course prices take off and then it doesn't work out and things fall through, or you know, they find another partnership, or they change what they're doing to adapt and prices shift because of that. So this is no different than buying into a company stock, right? If they're going to perform well and they're going to do well and it's going to grow, you're going to get great returns. And if you buy into something that's terrible, obviously it's no different.
Right. Lesson learned. Well, you're going to have to send me the podcast that you run, the links for those, as well as the Coinbase app, just a link maybe or a screenshot of what that looks like so I can post. And then you said the last link, the Coinbase website. I can't remember. Those are your action items after
CoinMarketCap.
You'll have to send that to me because I know inquiring minds. We're gonna want to know. So really, really appreciate you taking the time to come on here today. Yeah, it was really great. You're welcome anytime. I'm sure we're gonna get a lot of questions and interest after the fact here. So please do come back.
Well, thank you, Anthony. We love Land Title. We certainly appreciate you as a friend and resource to the show. And,
absolutely.
And, you know, professionally, obviously. We use Land Title. We're all about it. So thank you for the information. Yep. It was incredibly educational.
Absolutely.
It was awesome.
Yeah. Thank you for having me on. Appreciate you guys taking the time.
Thank you.
And we will put links to
all the stuff we're talking about
and everything that we're talking about below. So
thank you.
Awesome, guys. Well, it was a great show.
Go Avs.
Go Avs.
Yep. Yes.
Go at this.
Go get the cup. Go get that cup, guys. Yeah. And we'll leave you with a view of our backyard, our little patio. Have a good day.
Yeah. Sweet, guys. Thanks. Yeah.